I recently came out with a video on my workout in the morning, and a lot of students commented on it and asked me as to how important is it to be mentally and physically healthy. Well, it's one of the most important things because out of 24 hours, you don't need 24 hours to study. You need only probably 6 hours, 7 hours or 8 hours to be most productive in your studies. But out of these 24 hours, if you can spend 1 hour on mental and physical health, that increases your productivity in these 6 hours, 8 hours as well. What all do you need? You just need an empty space, a room like this, where you can sit early in the morning at probably 5 a.m., 6 a.m., spend 20 to 30 minutes on meditating. What is meditation? You just sit quietly, nothing else. You don't need to do anything. You don't need to think about anything. And that's all there is to meditation. What do you need for physical exercise? You don't need a gym, you don't need dumbbells, you don't need all kinds of tools, you just need your legs. So if you are healthy, if you have a pair of shoes, go out, start running, spend at least 30 minutes every day on your workout. Come back, spend a good 30 minutes, 1 hour resting, talking to your family members, or just sitting quietly having some tea. That's all there is to physical and mental workout. And believe me, if you do this for the next 6-7 months, your productivity is going to hit the roof. I remember in 2013, Gaurav Agarwal topped UPSC examination, and I was watching one of his interviews because I was very close to cracking UPSC myself at that time. And I wanted to fill all the gaps that existed in my preparation. But this one gap I could not fill because I did not know the importance of it. I realize it now. And coming back to Gaurav Agarwal, he said that out of 24 hours, he made sure that he spent 1 hour on meditating, on yoga, and on running for 20 to 30 minutes. And that ensured that he was most productive in the remaining 23 hours. I can also remember a story or an event which my brother shared with me recently. He went to South Korea on a trip for the government, and he told me that people there work out in the afternoon because they're very busy. They like to start their work early in the morning at 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock. That's the kind of lifestyle they have. So what they do is they would take out 2 hours in the afternoon. Let's say you're supposed to have lunch at, let's say, 3 o'clock. So they would move out of their offices at 1. They would spend 1 good hour on working and meditating. Then they would take a nice bath and they would get back to the office, and then they would have a nice lunch. And then they'll get back to work till 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock in the evening, and that's it. So this was their way of adjusting and finding out ways to staying physically and mentally healthy. You don't have to give that excuse that because you're studying, so you don't have enough time. In fact, I remember I always gave this excuse to myself, and that resulted in me gaining a lot of weight when I was preparing for UPSC or preparing for RBI, because I did not realize the importance of working out. But now I do. Now that I am working, now that I'm studying simultaneously, now that I'm teaching simultaneously, I'm able to do all these things because I understand the importance of physical and mental health. And I want all of you guys to have the same energy, have the same productivity, have the same lifestyle, so that majority of you are successful and make all of us, not only me, make all of us very proud. I'm very sure this small lecture on physical and mental health is going to certainly have some impact on some of you and help you change your mindset towards mental and physical workout. Don't spend a lot of time on it. 20 to 30 minutes on each of these two things is enough to change your perspective towards life, to change your perspective towards your studies, to change your perspective towards the definition of success itself. All the very best, guys. Take care. Have a nice day.